This is a NES case for a Raspberry Pi. What does it actually do though? Stick around to find out. It's TechWizTime. Hey guys, hope you're having a fantastic week. My name's Jonathan and this is TechWizTime, where I create technology tutorial and review videos. In this video, I'll be unboxing and going over the NES case that has been sent out to me. No money has exchanged hands and thoughts and opinions are definitely my own. So with that said, let's get unboxing. So if we open this up, inside is a colour little leaflet saying how to install the Raspberry Pi and so forth inside. Also included is a mini screwdriver, which will be really handy. And the actual case itself. Open it up, and there's the case. Doesn't look much like a NES case, but let's see what it's got inside. So underneath the top, you've got a fan inbuilt there with the little 2-pin power to plug into the Raspberry Pi. You've got some extra little screws inside, and the bottom of the case is where the magic happens. You've got an Ethernet cable, a USB cable, and what I assume is pass-through power. So when the Raspberry Pi 3 gets installed there, you still have access to the microSD card slot on the side. Although with the Raspberry Pi 3, because it's not the audio ejector type, it might be a little bit hard to get to. Actually, let's test that out. But first, let's screw it in. So now that it's screwed in, you can see the microSD card is in there and there's a little bit of a lip so you can get your microSD card out again. It's a really good design choice. Next up, we need to plug in the Ethernet and USB. Definitely easier to do when the Pi isn't installed in the case, I've got to say. And the instructions say where to plug in to the GPIO pins, the big power there. So really quick and simple. And lastly, the fan actually plugs into the front board here, just like that. So once you've closed up the case, you can just put in the screws and the case is put together all ready to go. So looking at the features of the case, we've got a power switch there and also a reset switch. Now there's a little front cover there, which reveals an additional 2 USB ports as well as the 2 USB ports there. Over on this side, we've got the microSD card slot. On the other side, we've got another hidden port, which is for Ethernet. And on the rear, you've got access to the 3.5mm headphone jack, as well as the HDMI port and power. Now, unless you're using any scripts, I probably wouldn't recommend using the power and the reset on the front. So think about that before actually using these. But with that said, that's the NES case that I'll have a link down in the description for you if you are interested in purchasing one for yourself. From Amazon, of course. So I just want to say thanks for watching this video. I've hit a few milestones this year with almost 20,000 subscribers, so I'm doing really well, I think. But that's not just all me, that's due to the viewers and the fans out there that are actually helping me to grow this channel. And they've been doing that by leaving comments on my videos and giving me ideas of what I should try or what things I should do differently. I always listen to the comments, even though I don't have enough time to answer every single one of them. So with that said, how they also help the viewers and fans is they help by sharing and liking this video. So if you can do that for me, that would be fantastic. And of course, if you're not a subscriber, then make sure you subscribe to this channel with the big red button. And if you are a subscriber, then make sure you hit that notify bell icon so you get notified of new videos whenever they get released. So again, thanks heaps for watching this video. And as always, imagine, learn, create.